Welcome back to the broadcast. Well, our next guest is a bona fide supermodel, and she's here in studio with us to talk about all the wonderful things she has going on and some really neat candles we've got here at the table. Please help us welcome Petra Nimkova to the broadcast. We're so glad you're here today.
I feel very welcomed already. I'm like, I'm
we had fun here.
We were getting ready to mix cocktails, right?
And we trade clothes too, so I dipped on that dress.
It would go to my ankles, so I can't do that.
Well, tell us a little bit, Petra, about what you've got going on. We were discussing during the break that you live in Haiti now. Yes. And of course you have this amazing foundation that you founded, basically after something not so great happened in your life. Tell us about that.
The whole journey started almost 10 years ago. December 26 is when my life and life of many people has changed, and I think many people can remember where they were exactly December 26, 2004, when a tsunami hit. It took 250,000 lives, and millions were impacted in many countries. And my life has been changed forever since as well, losing my partner, my pelvis broken. But one of the things which I've learned from that experience, that every experience has some negatives and some positives. And if you focus on the positives, you can become stronger and empower yourself and empower others through it. And that really, if I look at the journey for the last 10 years, that's what has happened. Without that experience, Happy Hearts Fund wouldn't be established. And at that time, with Happy Hearts Fund, we had the goal to build one school in 2006. And by the end of this year, we will commemorate the 10th anniversary of a tsunami with rebuilding of over 100 schools in 9 countries.
That is phenomenal.
Do you go back to Thailand?
Yes, we have 2 schools there. I'm going back also for the 10th anniversary commemoration. But I go to Thailand, I go to every country where we rebuild schools. And it really, it's you know, we all go through challenges in life and hardships in life, losing loved ones, sickness, but I think that those experiences are there to help us, to shape us in a certain way, and it can really make us stronger and put us on the right path and actually more happier path. Mm-hmm. Because you start appreciating the gift of life, and the presence is the present. And before, sometimes we take it for granted, but when life shakes us, mm-hmm. we start realizing and the priorities are different, and actually we live more in a happy way. So that experience was definitely hard, but personally, I live more happier and a fuller life with I always say living life fully and meaningfully. Mm-hmm. And it really has been that, and also through the foundation, we've been able to empower many children through having safe schools for them.
As you were trying to find the happiness inside yourself, how were you able to find the vision to help children in the midst of that?
Yeah, what happened is that as soon as I could walk again, I went back to Thailand, and that was the first time. It was about 4 months after. I healed very fast. Part of it, why I healed so fast, was the drive wanting to go back and help. Doing also lots of energy work and meditation and things like that. But as soon as I went back, I went to see what is the biggest need, number one, and number two, what we can do, what will have the biggest impact. Mm-hmm. And the biggest need, which I've seen for the first time and then in many other countries, is that when first responders leave, the support leaves as well. Mm-hmm. And they leave usually 6 to 9, maybe sometimes 1 year after the natural disaster, but then the communities are left without the support. So we find communities where they are waiting for a school, safe school, for 4 or 6 years. Mm-hmm. And 6 years is a whole primary school, and that children's lives, they go down the spiral, and the whole community goes down the spiral. So we are focusing exactly in that gap period. We come into places impacted by natural disaster when everybody's leaving and when it's not sexy to be there, mm-hmm. and we rebuild safe, resilient schools. And those are important because many countries have recurring natural disasters, mm-hmm. and it's in the last 10 years, in between 2004 and 2014, there has been 17% increase of natural disasters. Mm. And sadly, the projections are really bad. For the next 20 years, there will be an increase of 230%.
Okay, so we want to help.
Not to scare you, but it's...
Well, it'll get you going.
Yeah,
help out.
We need to know.
And now we have a way to help.
Yes.
And today, this is very exciting.
Yes, that's very exciting. So on a happy note, when you can rebuild Save Resilient School, you are preventing the loss of lives going forward. You are helping the whole, not just children, but the whole community, and people can do it through helping Happy Hearts, but also we have the other way. It's holiday season, so everybody's thinking about gifting something to their loved ones. So we have created this beautiful line from Be Delight New York of luxury candles, and they are all very meaningful gifts.
They are gorgeous. What a great hostess gift. Yes. Host of the holidays.
Yes. Candles. They are beautiful, meaningful in two ways. One, because each of them has... first of all, they all give back to Happy Hearts when they help to rebuild schools. Actually, four of these candles, they're inspired by countries where we rebuild schools. So it's Mexico, which you have, Haiti, Indonesia, and America. Nice. But also the second way they are meaningful, each of them, they have meaning in them. So every candle is inspired by a country, treasure of the country, and the meaning of the treasure. So thinking of a hostess gift, for example, the blue one, American Bluebell Bliss, the meaning of bluebells is gratitude, and we can be thankful every day, not just Thanksgiving, which we just had, but every day there's so much to be grateful for. And when we host friends around, it's a nice way to say I'm so grateful to have you in my life. The Indonesian patchouli piece, the silver one, is peacefulness. We are about to have a holiday, so Czech holiday cookie is all about family togetherness. And we have a beautiful tradition in Czech. We bake cookies together, the whole family, mom, dad, kids, everyone participates in some way. And then we glue the two parts of the cookies together with jam. But it's not just about gluing the cookies with jam, it's about gluing the family with love. And so that candle is inspired by that tradition. And for those, for example, who want to give something to their loved ones, I have something special for all the ladies here. Spanish saffron heat, this one, is... do you know the meaning of saffron by any chance?
No.
You need to know. Saffron is the spice of love. Mm-hmm. It also is also the most expensive spice. Mm-hmm. But
that explains it, Megan.
Yeah, I'm gonna rub myself all in saffron, light the saffron candles, and that's just gonna hook me up.
And on top of it, it used to be used as an aphrodisiac in the past.
Done. Lots of saffron.
I know what I'm getting, Megan, for Christmas. And of course, I mean, such an inspiration. Thank you so much for joining us today. Guess what? You can meet Petra today at Neiman Marcus North Park from 1 until 4 this afternoon. Pick up a Be the Light candle, too, while you're there. 10% of the proceeds will go to Petra's Happy Hearts Fund. And of course, you can give directly to the Happy Hearts Fund, too, by going to happyheartsfund.org.
So whoever comes...
chocolate.
Well, get a treat. These little chocolates, they are absolutely divine. One of them is inspired by the Mexican cacao mystic candle. And you have to try it, ladies.
Yes,
twist our arms.
So this one is caramel. This one is with a nut. This one is the 85% cacao. And I'm going for it. I'm not waiting for
it. All right. Awesome. And she eats chocolate. She's gorgeous.
Gotta love her. Yes. Okay, we'll be back with more broadcast right after this.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you.
So yummy.